nu nog een plaatje, maar hij kan hem nu op.
Oké. Zijn jullie bijna klaar voor?
We zijn er bijna klaar voor. Kijk, ja, daar zijn die.
Wacht even, voordat je gaat beginnen, dan gaan wij live.
Ja, nou.
Ready? Oké, Daan, hoor je me? We kunnen live in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Hoor je me niet? Oké. Hoor je me niet, Daan?
Ik doe die modulatie, doe ik rustig.
4, 3,
fijn als ik wel
2, 1.
You think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew, you never knew. Have you ever heard the wolf cry to the blue corn moon? Or ask the grinning bobcat why he grinned? Can you sing with all the voices of the mountain? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Come run the hidden pine trails of the forest. Come taste the sun-sweet berries of the earth. Come roll in all the riches all around you, and for once never wonder what they're worth. The rainstorm and the river are my brothers. The heron and the otter are my friends, and we are all connected to each other in a circle, in a hoop that never ends. How high does the sycamore grow? If we cut it down, then we'll never know. And we'll never hear the wolf cry to the blue corn moon. For whether we are white or copper skinned, we need to sing of the mountain. We need to paint with all the colors of the wind. You can own the earth and still all you own is earth.
Thank you.
It's not 10:30 yet, is it?
No. One more.
One more.
One more.
We've already an encore, Marnie.
I fall in love, it will be forever. This world like this is, love is ended before it's begun, and too many moonlight kisses seem to cool.
Jung, your debut on the piano on the live stream.
Like this, right?
Yeah, like that. Yeah.
Well, definitely. Not the debut, because I was with the other.
Yes.
Oh, yep, absolutely
duo.
Right.
Well, behind the roads.
Have a short seat, because we're going to introduce the test and Martijn.
Yeah.
For all the people that follow the live streams, they probably know your name, but they've never seen you.
No, I don't think so.
No. So this is Martijn ten Apel. He's been on the live stream for forever, it seems.
In the chat, you mean?
Yeah, in the chat. Yeah. Yes, yes. Well, he's today with us, and I'm really curious about what you think.
Well, I think, Martijn, you stand and stood out with your spot-on comments.
Absolutely.
On what we heard here and what you heard back home. So viewers, if you are as smart as he is, maybe next time you will be
next time you'll be sitting there.
And Martijn is also our reviewer for classical music.
Yeah.
Because
I almost forgot.
Of course, we like stuff, but we like music the most.
Yes.
And Martijn is reviewing classical music.
Classical music, yeah.
And he's a flute player.
Also,
as well.
Yeah.
That's a good point, by the way.
Yeah.
We like stuff, but we like music more. That's why we actually have live musicians in the room, because I think it's really important to know how it sounds in real life. Yes. But today we're going to review wireless speakers. It was one of your ideas as well to review the System Audio and the Buchardt. That's why Jung had the System Audio at home for a while. And
it was delivered to my place and I didn't let it go. So
it was that was actually the real story.
That was the real story.
They put it at home at your place. But it's here now. I have the Buchardt in house. We have the Devialet Phantom I 108, and that's actually the amount of decibels it can produce.
Sound pressure.
Sound pressure.
I didn't bring my
It's yeah. ridiculous, but it's a cool speaker. And we have the KAD K7, and that's a Dutch brand, KAD, made by Ernest. Ernest, and he has a history in electronics, of course. He worked at Intel for the telecom department. And now he's building speakers. So it's a really real technical loudspeaker, but we'll get to that later. Because you're going to record one more song.
Yes, we're going to record. I'll introduce Marnie when she's here. But
away at the
yes,
moment.
We're going to record one song, and because we have four four speakers, we are only playing live at the end of again at the end, so there's no
time.
We have a short intermission stuff from 1 minute when you can switch the speakers. We can
yeah, but these are really heavy.
Okay, then
he wasn't kidding. He wasn't kidding. These are 40.
What's the order? We begin with KAD.
Yeah, let's get to that. First, we do the KAD because it's the most heavy speaker, and now I'm still fit. So we take those away, then the Devialet, because they have to stay on. If I take away the power or power them off, I have to repair them as a stereo pair. They will work, but we have to repair them and put them in rune, and it's 5 minutes work, but it's too long for a live stream. After the Devialet, we do the Buchardt and then the system audio, and that's actually from most expensive to cheapest. I think that's more fair than from cheap to expensive, because you will forget about how well the cheaper versions play.
Well, it's something new. We didn't do that before, or did it randomly.
No, most of the time we did it randomly, yes. So what are you looking for in this test?
I'm curious to hear how good wireless speakers are.
Yeah.
I mean, because it's a speaker with its amplification inside, so the only thing that you need is to have a set of speakers and something to send a digital stream towards the speakers.
Yeah, true.
So I'm very curious how good it sounds, but also what the differences are between the different speakers which are on the market in the different price brackets.
Yeah.
Will you hear differences? How much will you hear?
Yeah.
And what I'm most curious about, what I hear when I am at home listening to the live stream with my headphones on over YouTube.
Headphones. Thank you.
You need people who are watching right
headphones.
Now. Headphones. Use headphones, please, because then you hear stuff that you cannot hear any other way.
You don't even have to have an expensive headphone.
No, a simple headphone, because you will hear the differences very, very clearly.
Yeah.
And I'm curious to see if I can hear those differences here as well, or if I'm when I'm home and listening over YouTube, I actually hear more than
so,
here.
Actually,
so
could be.
No, my experience is that the microphones will exaggerate the differences a little bit, because they're our brain does a lot of stuff, and we filter out a lot of stuff. Those microphones don't have a brain, so they won't filter out anything. So you can actually measure with the face thingy, we're not gonna tell to people, you know how face coherent the speaker is. And that's a funny thing, because these are all DSP powered.
Yes.
And they're so immensely accurate because of that. I think people have to get used to the accuracy of newer generation loudspeakers. So that's a thing that I noticed when we were building up the live stream on Friday. It's like, wow, they're really, really accurate.
Even more so than when we tested the active monitors.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, because of the DSP technology. They
sure.
can
yeah.
tune
it's
the
all
face
DSP'd, yeah.
so well. And you hear that. And these are very, very accurate, but they're big. So you get a little bit of well, it's not as accurate as a smaller speaker. It doesn't mean that that a smaller speaker sounds better, but it does confirm that I like two-way bookshelves more than floor-standing loudspeakers in general, I think. The more you do this, the more you learn.
But this speaker, let's say the old-school way, so just plus and minus in the back, would measure
worse. Absolutely. Yeah, depending on the price category, of course. But
so
a Wilson Audio will measure very, very well, I think.
Utopia.
Yeah, those will do.
So, okay.
But then again, if you have to buy things like Wilson Audio
to get this performance,
to get this performance, then this is a bargain, I think.
It's a bargain, yeah. Is Marnie ready?
Yeah.
Okay, then we can do the recording.
Marnie, come over here, please.
You were hiding. You were hiding.
Yes, because you were
hiding
your hello.
Hi.
Hi, this is Marnie.
Okay, this is Marnie Baumer. Marnie, can you tell us something about yourself? Because
she's very dark. She's not well lit, actually. Okay.
Okay. Hi. I'm Marnie. I am a singer, actress, and voiceover artist. I originally come from Michigan in the United States, and I've gone to school in Detroit.
Yeah.
And lived in Chicago, and New York City, and London, and now Leiden. And that's my. What more do you want to know?
Well, I'm curious on what kind of music we're going to hear just now.
Yeah,
and, well, when you asked, and later on, yeah.
Okay, great. So you asked me what I would like to sing today.
Yeah.
And I'm often hired to do musicals or sing with the orchestras, and it's usually their repertoire. And this was the first time I get to, like, in a while, actually sing what I want to sing, because I used to do cabaret mm-hmm. in New York City and Chicago and write whole shows. So what I decided to do today is pick some of my favorites.
Ooh.
My personal faves.
And so this song we're going to record is your personal favorite then?
The actual song, the
live
song?
We're going to do it just after our talk, we're going to record.
Okay, so about this song particularly.
Yeah.
It's written by Francesca Blumenthal from New York City. And I did a show for Francesca back in the day, and a couple of her shows. And this is one of her most famous songs. It's called The Lies of Handsome Men. And it's one of my favorites to sing. And Francesca just passed away.
Yeah,
last week.
She was the one also writing for Barbara Streisand.
She's done.
That's Ellen Merlin Bergman.
Oh, this is Bergman, sorry.
Yeah. There's Francesca. She's a fantastic songwriter, extremely witty. And she actually wrote a song for me for my auditions when I lived in New York City as well, called 16 Bars. But I decided that Liza
Hansen.
We're not going to do that one today. No, but it's really fun. And she passed away. So I thought this would be a great chance to give Light a big audience online to hear the song, which is one of my personal favorites, and she was an amazing woman. So
I'm very, very, very curious.
Yeah, playing with Marnie the past couple of days, has I found out there's so much more in the American songbook than we know. From we know musicals, we know Broadway, West End, maybe the Disney stuff. But what you are doing is something that's so well. I think it's very interesting musically, but also lyrically.
And, yeah.
Just find out. So
yeah, I agree. I was here on Friday, of course, when they rehearsed, and it was different than I was used to with the musical.
It
the
is.
Musical was mostly rah and lots of.
It's more like cabaret, more small,
intimate. Yeah.
Intimate, yeah.
I liked it.
And a lot of these shows, some of them actually are from musicals, and some of them are from The Colors of the Wind is from Pocahontas from Disney. And I had a show, Animato and G, which is a tribute to women in animated film. Mm-hmm. And When I Fall in Love is from in everything.
In
films, everything. Yeah. It's just a.
We had both goosebumps.
Yes.
It was really nice.
Super cool.
So take the stage,
Marnie. Lies of Handsome Men.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's not the tagline of this show, The Lies of Handsome Men.
Yeah.
We're not lying, are we?
Oh, yeah.
With, all handsome men, so this is perfect.
Let's go. Moet daar even in het licht zetten zo, want het is te donker.
We'll wait for the recording sign.
Oh.
Dynasty, yes, it's on.
Okay, there we go.
I believe in star signs, and I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy. And I believe with just one glance, he's crazy for my eyes. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. I believe in witchcraft. I believe in Cinderella. I believe in gypsies. And I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere in the corner of my mind, I'm not a fool, completely blind. And even though he's hooked me on his line, I find the pleasure's been mine. I believe in love songs. They seem to know just what I'm feeling. I believe Prince Charming. I never guess he's double dealing. How my spirits rise, believing in the lies of handsome men. Sometimes in a dark and quiet place, the truth and I meet face to face. And even if His Highness disappears, I keep some stunning souvenirs. So I believe in heroes, and I expect that happy ending, wishing on some rainbow. Someday I'll get wise, but right now I need the lies of handsome men.
Yay! Woo!
Thank you, Marnie. Some people asked for your name.
My full name? Marnie Baumer.
Yeah. So they said it sounded lovely and effortless.
Oh, beautiful. Thank you.
Yes. Very nicely done. Thank you very much.
Sit there.
I'm going to put her a little bit more into the... Can you look for a lighter spot for her, Jung? So the...
Yes, I'm checking with
so much in the dark.
Erik. What's better over there?
She deserves a better spot.
I think so. Here.
Your Highness? Your Highness.
Even if Your Highness disappears?
Oh, there's light. Yes.
Light
yeah, that's
good. I got all my liquids here.
Okay.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, that's much better.
Yeah.
A little bit more forward, maybe. Otherwise, you're up against the wall.
Maybe, yeah. Yeah,
so
that's perfect. Perfect. Thank you.
Now, thank you.
You shouldn't be in the shades. About the test tracks. Of course, we have Jacques Louché.
Yes, of course we have.
Of course.
Yes.
sorry about that.
Yeah, Martijn was one of the advocates who did a petition to get rid of Jacques
yes.
Louché, but.
We also have a new track. You can tell more about that.
Yes. Well, I write about classical music. I think one of the things, a lot of people who like classical music are also very much invested into this kind of equipment.
I think so.
I
yeah.
think so.
Yeah.
Because you hear so much on it. It's largely acoustic, of course, when you hear classical music, and acoustic instruments have a different kind of tonality than electrical instruments. your ears are far more fine-tuned to it, I think. But also, this is I chose a big orchestra track.
Okay.
Just to hear what a big orchestra sounds like on these kind of speakers.
Mm-hmm.
You can hear a lot in placement. And I chose a recording of Bruckner, the Ninth Symphony, and then the second part, and then we play about one less than 2 minutes.
Usually
of
it would take the whole live stream to listen
Bruckner
to
Bruckner Symphony number 9,
yes.
4 movement version.
Yeah, and this
Studio Masters.
Yes.
Yeah.
And this particular one is the Berliner Philharmoniker Orchestra with Simon Rattle on the helm directing.
Okay.
That's a magical combination. It's a modern recording.
Yeah.
And it sounds absolutely superb. So
on a good system.
On a good system, yeah.
Yeah.
Where is it recorded? Is it recorded in their own?
It's in the hall, recorded in Berlin. Yeah.
All right. Let me check if we're still on schedule because I really want to tell something about the wireless technologies as well. Maybe after this one.
Because we're now listening.
We're right on track. Start test. Okay.
We are.
Well, yeah, we are. very short. You have a couple of methods to do wireless audio. You have WISA. That's an international standard.
WISA.
WISA. It's used by Bang & Olufsen, Harman, the KAD, the Buchardts, and the System Audios. It's 5 gigahertz, but out of band for Wi-Fi, so it can't be. It can't interfere. It's impossible. You also have clear audio. That's used by DALI. For example, it's also out of band for wireless, so it's you can't interfere there as well. The Devialet uses Wi-Fi. Then it all depends on how well it's done.
And Sonos also using Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi, they have their own mesh networking system. Blue Sound uses Wi-Fi. The thing with Wi-Fi is that it completely depends on how well it's done. With WISA or clear audio, you have a platform that's pretty much bulletproof. If you do the software well, then it should work. And that's why I think KAD uses the WISA standard and Buchardt and System Audio as well. You just buy their platform and then you build your loudspeaker on that. And I think that's a good choice. I must admit, I didn't have any issues with Devialet. Nothing. It just works. So they did it well. I did have some other brands that did give issues. We're not going to go into that because it's not important, but that's something to keep in mind when you choose a wireless speaker, I think. I think we should just go on with the KAD.
And then Bruckner first?
Bruckner first, yeah. Let's see. They have to be.
This is part one, I think.
Yeah.
Where should I start?
Second part from Bruckner.
So two minutes approximately we listen.
It's the same track.
No, it's no. Other track.
Okay.
Sorry.
Then we start with Jacques, and then I'll search for the other one. Okay.
Thank you.
right? Some people ask if you could sit beside us because you're completely out of
thank you, some people.
Out of frame. Yeah, and it feels a bit distant. So
yeah.
Maybe and then we can some people also ask the price.
Over here? Right.
Yeah, you can sit next to me. Yeah.
Kan dat
jawel. Okay. It's just around here. It's okay.
Cozy.
Cozy. Yeah, a little bit.
Better?
Yeah, I had my tests and vaccinations and all sorts of stuff. So, the price of the KAD is 14,950. So it's around 15,000 euros. There's going to be some discount for people that are watching now. So if you're interested, this is your time. I don't have any stock in KAD or any affiliates with them, so you know that. I'm completely independent. About KAD, it's a very powerful system, and you can hear it, I think.
Yeah. It's, do they make more? Is this what they make, or do they have more stuff?
More there are speakers? Some flavors in unit.
But they don't make passive units or no. Amplifiers or...
No. They use Encore. All of them are Class D. Let's start with that, because you can't build in a Class A or AB amplifier inside a speaker. It gets really hot, so that's not very...
There's no smaller...
No, not yet.
I mean, this is what they make up to now, so they...
Yeah.
Wow.
These have the expensive Seos units. So the beryllium tweeter, made by Seos, also used in the Grim LS1BE,
yes.
By the way.
Yeah.
The same mid-tone ceramic version, I think it was. Grim uses the bigger one in the LS1. I think you can recognize the gold cone in the
yeah,
middle.
The gold cone is
yeah,
quite
that,
the
that's the trademark of
it
that
It has
unit.
A Dapolito.
And it's Dapolito. Very well, you. Very well. It's also a cardioid design, and I didn't say anything about that. There are also woofers at the back that are powered, and because of some clever tricks in the processing, you have a cardioid radiation pattern. So you can place it pretty much back to the wall without any issues. That's very nice.
Well, that's also one of the Dapolito
eigenschappen.
Yeah. Properties.
Two DA converters per speaker. It's 20 hertz to 25 kilohertz, so it's full range. It has, I think it was it's two amplifiers per loudspeaker, two for the woofers. One for the woofer, front and back, and one for the mid-highs. But they're all two channels. We have four channels.
Yeah.
That's and it's ridiculously powerful. I think it's 1500 watts per loudspeaker. So you can pretty much tease your
neighbors.
So
you can have a big party at home.
A big party without any issues. Yes.
Okay.
We put all the technical information in the article anyway. But it reminded me of Dutch and Dutch, in terms of design. It's also cardioid design.
Okay.
But what did you think, Martijn? About the sound,
It's very tight. It's the pacing is very good of this speaker. There's a lot of drive in it.
Yeah.
When I listened to the bass in this Jacques Lussier track, I thought the bass was a bit dominant over the other instruments.
Mm-hmm.
I was missing some of the piano was also falling backwards a bit in the whole image. I think.
A little bit.
Yeah. And it sounds different than when you're listening at home with your headphones on over YouTube. Definitely.
It is different. Yeah, it is different. But the I think the characteristics will be captured.
Yeah.
Yeah. But in terms of sound stage,
yes,
it's
different.
It's really hard to capture that, by the way. It's extremely hard.
Yeah.
But pricing, 15,000, it's a lot of money. But you only need a pair of speakers and one WiSA hub. That's it.
That's nice.
The WiSA hub is WiSA is included. I take it.
WiSA.
The WiSA hub is included.
If it's included, then you'll take it.
No, it's a question.
No,
question mark.
That's out. No, no, no. It's only speakers.
It's only speakers.
Now you can get a Primara Weiser hub for that money. It's not a cheap unit, but it's also not a very expensive unit. It's the we play with the Primara I15, and it's Weiser compatible. I think that's awesome.
Oh, okay. The speaker. Yeah, I see.
Okay. Next track. Let's see if it's already here.
Never
your track.
Do we have Bruckner?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we have it. Okay. Yeah. But let's do the live track.
Yes.
First.
I hate listening to my own recording.
There we go, people.
I will judge it for you. Don't worry.
I will do the blind edition.
I believe in star signs, and I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy, and I believe with just one glance he's crazy for my eyes. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Witchcraft. I believe in Cinderella. I believe in gypsies. And I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere in the corner of my blind. And even though he's hooked me on his line, I find the pleasure's been mine. I believe in love songs. They seem to know just what I'm feeling. I believe Prince Charming. I never guess he's double dealing. How my spirits rise, believing in the lies of handsome men. Sometimes in a dark and quiet place, the truth and I meet face to face. And even if His Highness disappears, I keep some stunning souvenirs. So I believe in heroes, and I expect that happy ending, wishing on some rainbow. I pretend he's not pretending. Someday I'll get wise, but right now I need the lies of handsome men.
It's ridiculously good.
I'm so sorry. I don't mean to like cry. So, wow. What did like to hear that just went through, and then came out there. We literally just did that.
Yes.
And like, I'm so grateful. I'm so happy that we could do this. I feel like Francesca like was, like
she's
present,
looking at
man.
You.
I don't have any words. It's ridiculously good.
We just heard her sing live here, which is different than hearing it through amplification and with all the reverb edit and stuff like that, because it's a very dry room here.
Yeah.
But what amazes me is that the character of your voice
captured
is
so
with
well.
All the layering, which you cannot hear normally through an audio system.
No.
But when you hear someone sing live in front of you, you can hear all those overtones and nuances and stuff. It's here. It's unbelievable.
The build.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
It's this. Wow. This
and
is
the piano
very impressive.
Was very good. The piano. I like. Yes. I like yes. the piano player. Yes. Yes. What a man! What
by
a man!
By the way, you just got the music what 5 days ago yeah. or so? Yeah.
But
amazing.
I
Thank
have
you
to
so much.
Say something about recording, because we used not the we didn't use modern microphones, but we used
old, yeah,
vintage RCA. Maybe I can yeah. just is it possible, Erik?
Yeah, it's a it's such a cool microphone. It's ridiculous.
And,
super cool. Super cool.
Yeah. Thanks to Martijn and Patrick, of course. maybe you can switch on, but this is the RCA microphone from the 30s, I guess.
Yeah.
But this one is yeah. very heavy.
And
they just repaired the power supply for it. So this is tube. And here we also have, I don't want to move it, but here on the back of the piano, we also have a vintage tube microphone. And what's very special for recording engineers is that we have a XY small membrane microphone.
For the piano, yeah.
Yeah, behind my ass, here.
So, sort of, yeah.
But it's, that was funny.
You know, unless I don't do something with my ass, it sounds wonderful and it sounds very spatial. And actually, the piano is not that good, but as Martijn,
oh, no.
Martijn, you told with these microphones, the piano sounds better than in real life because it's a pretty yep. modest piano.
Yeah.
And Marnie's voice, of course, you heard it. It's, you know, the layering, it yes. gets layering so well. Yeah. But imagine that this microphone is almost 100 years old.
Yeah, wow. It is. Yeah, it's amazing.
You know, it's just after Wall Street, 1929 or so, it's made.
Okay. We're on a tight schedule, Jung. I'm very sorry.
But, you know, the recording does something, because when we use modern microphones, you have different atmosphere, different.
Yes.
Kudos to our sound engineer. It yep. seemed that, like this track was mixed for hours, but an incredible voice. I agree. He's really good at it. Okay. Let's get to the last track, your track. I don't know the track, so I have
yep.
to.
I'm very curious.
Yeah. Okay. Second part.
Second part.
Just from the beginning.
Yep.
Okay, there we go. Let's go. More, yeah. I want more as well, but that's big work.
This is big work, yeah. Yeah.
Huge.
Yeah.
I don't know this piece. You can tell more about it.
Yeah. Well, there are a few things which I I mean, there's a lot of power coming from these speakers. It's huge. That's impressive.
Yeah.
But it's a bit on the dry side, and it's a bit on, I don't know. There's a rhythm and a pacing which is unbelievable with the speakers.
Mm-hmm.
But it gets a little bit, I want to have some more reverb, or I don't hear the concert hall in this, on these speakers. I'm missing the concert hall. And also in the copper players, the horns, and in that last part with the scales going up, I'm missing the very loud kind of reverb and sound of the horns, and that I'm missing on these speakers.
Could it be the dry room?
It could be the dry room, because I didn't hear these speakers before, and I don't know what it sounds like in this room.
No.
So it can be that it is the room I'm hearing, but I'm missing something in that regard. But the pacing of these speakers, I mean,
They're very fast.
They're very fast, yeah.
I do recognize a lot of the Grim LS1 in this one. You?
Yep.
I can hear the signature of the sales units a little bit.
But
very accurate.
To me, the mid-range is a little bit too much up front.
Yeah.
And that, when the mid-range is too much up front, you lose soundstage. I think you're talking about that.
I guess you're right. Yeah.
So the balancing between the balancing sound could be better, and we have there are possibilities to adjust. I think
they are. It's DSP controlled, so he can tune it. It's easy.
But that's what I also found at Jacques Lussier. That's why I think that's why the balance in these three, the double bass, the piano, and the drums are not as it should be or could be.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's something when you would tweak the mid range a little bit.
Tiny bit. Okay. I'm gonna swap for the Devialet. You have an intermezzo number?
Yeah.
Track, sorry?
I do.
Yeah?
But what do you think, listening to these guys?
I'm so excited.
These handsome men.
I'm so excited. I can't stand it. It's amazing. It sounds amazing.
Yeah.
And it's mind-boggling to think that we literally just did it there.
Yeah.
And they went through all this and came out here so full. And so, yeah. Because it's such an intimate song, but you still hear that it's intimate,
even though
it's loud.
Yeah.
And
it's, you know, you feel like you're, it's an intimate situation.
Did you hear your voice?
Yes.
I did.
Yeah.
I did, which was interesting because yesterday when we did a sound check, I had the headphones.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we chose not to use them today.
No.
Not because it was bad or anything, just, vanity.
Mm-hmm.
And, no, but we decided there were more factors, actually. I just made a joke. But I didn't hear myself back. And there's also, when I'm recording, I'm conscious of listening to myself back. I like to hear how does it work and this is the big picture. But this, I just sang it and trusted it. And this is what we got.
Yeah.
So it was interesting to do such a recording without like hearing yourself back in the Cope telephone.
Okay.
But it's really lovely. It's beyond anything I could imagine.
I agree. Your voice, these is
amazing. Yeah. I was like, first note, like, wow.
Yeah. Now we gotta keep up.
Yeah, keep it up.
Keep it up.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys, thank you.
All right. Steekkarretje.
I'll just start.
Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad, but the world goes round. And sometimes you lose every nickel you've had, but the world goes round. And sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a fall and a spring. And sometimes a friend starts treating you bad, but the world goes round. And sometimes your heart breaks with a defiant
Another one?
Yeah.
Yeah, another one.
Yeah. Another one.
Nog een keer doen.
Short one, ja.
Nog een keer.
Vanaf het begin. Ja. Gewoon lekker hetzelfde doen. Ja, oké.
Okay. We zijn 1 minuut.
Gewoon lekker spelen.
Ja, klaar.
We hebben over de sound. Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad, but the world goes round. And sometimes you lose every nickel you've had, but the world goes round. And sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a fall and a spring. And sometimes a friend starts treating you bad, but the world goes round. And sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. Yeah.
Now I have to do some noise.
Okay.
The deafening sound.
I'm sorry for this, it has to be done. Martijn, kan je hem op mono?
Ja.
Oké. Dan. Die is goed. Ja.
Yes?
Yes. Dan moet hij hem even vinden, zo te zien.
Is it visible on TV?
I think so.
This black.
Yeah. Okay. Iets anders, hè? All right. We are
in France.
We have the Devialet. Jun.
Devialet.
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 On l'appelle Devialet.
Devialet. Okay.
Alors, qu'est-ce que je peux en dire, hein? Devialet, I think, it's French. It's not that, it's a pretty young company. And what it does is it tries to compete with a high-end expensive design audio equipment like Bang & Olufsen.
Yeah, I guess so.
Experience is key and prices are high. That's more or less what they... And they were very clever in funding, because I dug into the company's history, and they had some moments of let's say, startup and then scale up. And what they did is they tried to find funding for every step, and they succeeded in that. And they even got the owner of Elm, of Moët & Chandon, and
the big
Louis Vuitton. Yep. That one is one of the was or is one of the owners and people who paid for the development. So these Devialet Phantom, there are two types, one and two. These are one type. One is the more powerful.
Yeah.
One, and they have different numbers ranging from 98 to, I think, 110 or so, 108.
108 is the loudest. Yeah,
and that stands for the sound pressure level, and for non-technical
the
people,
amount of watts you get.
108 dB, it's a deafening sound. It's really a deafening sound.
108 is a lot.
It's what you have usually at parties or at festivals. which we cannot go right now.
When you're standing behind a jumbo jet, I think.
Yeah, that's 140, but we played 105 for like 2 minutes once in the listening room, and it was really loud.
Talking about classical music, most conductors are deaf.
Yeah, they are.
Because, you know, when you're standing in front of 100 people,
that's a lot.
Doing their thing, it's a lot of decibels.
Yeah.
Okay, it's wireless and they don't use a hub, so it's fully
fully wireless.
Attached to your Wi-Fi system.
Yeah.
It has a titanium tweeter per speaker, and you wouldn't imagine it's 1100 watts and 180 dB on 1 meter. No distortion, frequency range is 14 hertz at the lowest, until 27 kilohertz. And it has an own DAC 2496 kilohertz. You control it as, we called it a Sonos on stereo, steroids. You know, Sonos, it's 10 times the price, or maybe 20, or maybe, you might know more. But it's, and you can also have it in gold. It's at the Paris Opera Garnier. There is a Phantom experience room. So they do everything to get people, buying it, and they're pretty successful, I must say.
They are.
I
thought the whole setup is pretty cool. I mean, it looks like some sort of creature from Predator. Sci-fi speaker.
And you could share, when you unboxed it and you set it off, share with it how that works.
It's so cool. I mean, I'm not really into these kinds of products because they're more focused on lifestyle than on musical performance. But as a reviewer, you have to step back and say, okay, for whom is this and what do they expect? And I unboxed it, I powered it, and then the woofers go like, boom. I say, okay, that's cool. That's a cool feature. Then you open the app and it says, an entrance is found. I say, whoa, okay. Don't be scared. Okay. And then you set it up and you put it in a room in your app, and then it says touch me, and then you touch
the speaker, says touch,
touch
me.
The speaker, and then it goes like, and then it's initiated.
In
okay,
fresh.
Yes,
it's
kudos
experience.
To the setup. It's
okay.
An experience.
Total experience.
It's really awesome, and it makes me happy. They just offer you something they don't have to, because the setup procedure is mostly pretty boring. It's like, I'm connected. Okay, cool, you're connected. But this is like a whole different universe built around the speaker, and they did an awesome job. And
The stands are beautiful. They're beautiful. Integrated with the...
The power cord is integrated in the stand, so you put it on the bottom, so you don't have a cord hanging.
Yeah.
Okay, that's nice.
Something to think about.
Yes.
Yeah, aesthetically pleasing.
Yeah, well,
How does it sound?
It goes with the price.
Yes, how does it sound?
3,000 a piece.
Yeah.
So 6,000 a pair, and...
That's without
often the stands, when you negotiate with your dealer, you can
get them for free.
Get them for a good price.
They're always.
Let's listen to
Jacques Loucher.
Oh, French music on a French speaker.
Jacques Loucher,
It should be a match. So. Thank you.
Well, that was something completely different.
Completely different?
Yes. Well, this is the opposite of dry.
Yeah. Definitely, yes.
Very French.
There's a lot of grease in the injected in the sound. Yeah.
Yeah, you nailed it. It's the opposite of dry. This is very much made a lot bigger than it is. But it's cool.
Yeah, but the pressure you can't. The pressure that you feel from these speakers.
Yeah.
I mean, the other ones, those were impressive big beasts, but the pressure coming from these two alien things is unbelievable.
Yeah, so someone call it the Daft Punk helmet. I think that's I think that's very accurately put.
Yes. we should play that, yeah.
Oh, it's got that can't be 11,000 watt now. I think it's around 1500 watts per speaker.
Yeah, 1100. Yeah,
something like that.
Yeah.
We'll look it up. It's a lot.
One of the things that I noticed compared to the other speakers that we just heard before is that the left hand and the right hand of the piano were very distinguishable. How do you say it?
Distinguishable.
Distinguishable. Yeah. That's the right word.
Did you hear too?
Yeah. So it's more separated. So you hear the left and the right hand on the piano much better. And the bass was going.
Wow.
I don't know how deep it was, but it was pretty deep.
Yeah.
It almost felt like you're inside the piano.
Yeah. It's ridiculous. Yeah.
It's very close mic.
I could feel like the top being open, like sticking my head inside it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very present.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And it plays forward mostly for my feeling.
Yes.
Not in the depth.
No.
No. The stage was forward, much more like this.
And very wide.
I must admit, it's better than I thought.
Yes.
You had some prejudices.
I had some prejudice, yes, I have to admit. I thought it was like, a lot of bass and a lot of spectacle. Because on high-end Munich, when we were there, it was just very loud. It was awful. And I never heard one in a decent way. It's a lot better than I thought.
Because what we just do is we played through Rune. Yeah. Rune recognizes the VLS and there's nothing in between.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. It just recognizes the stereo
speaker,
pair as a stereo system, and you just say enable, and we're playing.
Oh, that's how you like it with digital audio.
Yeah.
That can be finicky still.
Really easy.
That's nice.
My grandma can install this.
Yeah.
She will be scared by the moving woofers, but
<That's>
she can do
no
it.
No way.
What?
No way, dirty man.
I'm okay. Not gonna... Your track.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Yes.
Again. Here we go. Again. Oh, yeah.
Cool. Now we're going to compare.
Three times.
Oh my.
Four times.
Four times in total. There we go. I'm
four
really
times
curious.
A lady.
I believe in star signs. And I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy, and I believe with just one glance he's crazy for my eyes, 'cause I believe the lies of handsome men. I believe in witchcraft, I believe in Cinderella, I believe in gypsies, and I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies, 'cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere in the corner of my mind, I'm not a fool. Blind. And even though he's hooked me on his line, I find the pleasure's been mine. I believe in love songs. They seem to know just what I'm feeling. I believe Prince Charming. I never guess he's double dealing. How my spirit
now I need the light of handsome men.
Oh, there
well,
we go.
Well,
Joen. Yeah.
It's like the piano has a, there's a kunstgebit in it.
Yeah, and then of course it's your piano.
What is a kunstgebit in English?
A fake teeth.
If there are fake teeth beneath the hammers and the, you hear everything, and also you're in your head.
Yeah.
It's like a magnifying glass.
Yeah.
But it picks up all the little speckies on the. It picks up everything.
But still, I wasn't as immersed as the KADs because they were just more natural sounding. And I know this is not supposed to be a hi-fi speaker. It's for people that are looking for something cool.
Yeah.
They don't look for absolute neutrality. But in this case, I thought your voice was just not your voice on this loudspeaker.
No, it took on a higher tone. It felt higher. Like everything felt higher. Everything felt brighter.
Yeah. Yeah.
As well.
It's as if everything is amplified.
It's amplified, yeah. But smaller. I can't explain that.
No, I get what you
mean.
Yeah,
like,
you know,
like,
I know what you mean. Yeah.
It's coming through a tube that only has so much room to go through, and then.
Yeah.
You mean compression?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe it is compression. But it has to compress in some ways. Otherwise, it won't play 108 dBs.
Yeah, and it compresses well when you play, let's say, pop music or.
Band, like a full band, or something.
But this is very tiny, and now it says, "Okay, I have a piano. You know, boom! I have to do that. Okay, and I have to."
I think if you have, I mean, we are listening now to different speakers, so we can compare. If you have a set of these at home, and you are working, and you have music playing on the background or doing anything,
very then ambient, it's, very nice.
Yeah, then it's very nice because. The music envelops you. It's all around you with the speakers.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to hand it to the KADs here before. I mean,
that was
your
really
voice.
It was beautiful.
That was beautiful.
Yeah, it was really good.
So we need to make sure that everybody that listens to me singing has to go out and get those speakers.
I guess he will be really happy.
Otherwise,
I guess so.
Like,
yeah.
Be KAD ambassador, Marty.
Oh man.
Maybe the other speakers.
I don't know. We haven't
we'll
heard the Buchardts or the system audios yet.
There's two more to go.
It's really amazing how the sound, just the different things you hear.
Yeah.
With the different speakers.
Yes.
It's amazing, yeah.
It's really.
Well, that's something we want to show to people.
It's really important.
Yeah. It's
but they're at home right now listening on headphones, you said as well.
They should.
Some
headphones.
Some do listen on iPads, but
you
wouldn't recommend it.
Last song. The Symphony Number 9. This is big work, so I'm really curious.
Bigger.
That was
dynamic, but you heard the compression.
Yes, it started much louder than on the previous one, right. And also the difference in dynamics is less. Yep.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I heard it as well.
Yeah. In the last passage, where you hear the cellos playing underneath the horns, it was completely a tight mess. It didn't flat. You didn't hear the cellos anymore. And also the flute, the characteristics of the sound of the flute was very different and not correct. I'm going to make a very bad classical joke. It was like von Karajan directing instead of Rattle. he probably understands what I mean.
I don't. But
Herbert von Karajan was a very famous conductor in, I think, the...
Well, starting from the 1939 until he was... Chief conductor of the Berlin
Philharmonic for a long time, and his recordings are famous. But he was famous for playing big and playing loud.
Well, the joke was it was Karajan playing Mozart, Karajan playing Bach, where it was always from Karajan.
Everything is loud.
Yeah. Everything is loud. Okay.
He was compared to a bus.
Yeah.
It was always so pompous.
Yeah. So listening to this, it's very different from, I don't well. It's impressive. It impresses when you hear this the first time, but
Well, I think it's for another target group.
Yeah. I was just thinking that.
It's a lovely product. It looks absolutely amazing. Yeah. It's an experience. It's technically really impressive what they do. I mean, it's the smallest speaker of all, and they cost 6,000 a pair. The KADs are 15,000 a pair. I mean, let's be honest.
Yeah.
That's a lot. That's a big difference.
This is what people like in a living room.
And I think if you shouldn't buy this if you like classical music, I think.
Could you put the compression off?
I don't think so. But we'll dive into that. I mean, for now, I don't really like speakers doing compression when they shouldn't. That's something I have a difficulty with that because your voice was obviously compressed.
Yeah. But when he recorded it, it wasn't. It was just straight through the microphone.
No, and through this speaker, you could hear.
You could hear your voice.
Oh, it's layering.
Yeah. But maybe we'll get to the Buchardt next.
Yeah. I'm curious.
Maybe it's just the price difference, and we're spoiled by the KAD.
We started
with the most expensive one.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. So we'll see.
I'm going to bet on that.
I'm going to swap the speakers.
We're going to play.
You're going to play.
Same thing, Marnie?
Oh, the same.
Or do you want another one?
Are we doing later the other two?
Yeah. Yeah, we can do. How much time do you need?
What say you?
How much time do you need?
2 minutes.
You say.
Okay, we'll just continue. This is our just changing the sound. We're gonna test it out again with the new speakers. Yeah. Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad while the world goes round. And sometimes you lose every nickel you've had, but the world goes round. And sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a fall, and a spring. And sometimes a friend starts treating you bad, but the world goes round. And sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. Somebody loses and somebody wins, then one day it's kicks, and it's kicks in the shins, but the planet spins and the world goes round and round. Mm-hmm.
dat ik bijna klaar was van daar. Ja, daar van daar. Ik dacht nou in plaats van... The world goes round. Da 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 da. That's what we do in America.
En dan moet ik hem even inrazen. Tijn, kan jij hem op mono gooien voor het ruisen? Oké. Buchardt. Boas.
Zo. Snel een broodje pakken.
Zie je het?
Ja.
Ik heb alleen niet de toe in van deze, maar is die kant op niet.
Is het goed nog? Oké. Oké.
Hij moet een klein beetje...
Naar buiten?
Deze kant op.
Dat is nogal belangrijk. Ja. Ja. Perfect. Perfect.
Pitch perfect.
Perfect. Ja. Oké. Okay. Buchardt. Yeah, I'm sorry, we have to do this every speaker, otherwise you won't get the experience you need to compare them. If we don't align them and put them correctly, we can't hear how they perform. And you will get a very distorted stream from us. Buchardt A500. Mats Buchardt is on the stream, so I hope I pronounce his brand well. Otherwise, he can put it in the chat. this is the bookshelf version, active, WISA. It's around 3,500 a pair, without stand mounts and without the hub. But just like with the Devialet, you can get a package deal. You can get the hub included, and you will get a discount on the hub, of course. It's 3x150 watts of class D per speaker. So that's 450 watts per speaker. It has a very small tweeter, as you can see. But it has a very nice dispersion...
Waveguide.
Waveguide, yep. System in it. It reminds me of Amphion. And that's also a Scandinavian brand. So maybe Mats can put in the chat why he chose for this configuration.
Design, yeah.
It's on the website, so people can also click to the website, and he explains very detailed why they use a tweeter like this. But he can explain it in the chat far better than I can. It has a 6-inch mid-woofer and a 6-inch woofer on the back.
Yeah.
So it's a closed system with two woofers and a very small tweeter. It's really small.
And it looks nice.
Yeah, they look very well finished.
Very subjective remark, but...
What do you think?
Simple but elegant.
Simple but elegant. Yeah, it's Scandinavian,
yeah.
So that's simple but elegant.
Yeah, there you go.
There you go.
Spot on, man.
It's DSP controlled, of course. You can... I can tell for hours about the app. I'm not gonna do that. Martijn is gonna take them home with the system audios as well. He's gonna compare them in depth.
and he can tell everything about the app and the room correction and the DSP controls, and it's a very technical loudspeaker.
Yes.
They
all are technical.
Yeah,
in
they
a
are.
Way.
Yeah.
KAD is also technical.
Very.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The nice thing about system audio and this, the Buchardts, is that you can download different tunings of the speaker.
That's a pretty cool feature.
From their website, and then try out different tunings, which fits the best for
your room,
that's your ears or your taste.
This is the standard configuration. Yep. I'm going to forward a mail to you from Mats, in which he included the new master tunings. You can use those, he says. The old ones are not going to be supported anymore, but we couldn't change them just a day before the stream, because otherwise I fuck up stuff and I wouldn't be able to test this loudspeaker.
Well, that's the thing with the digital stuff like this.
You can break them.
Yeah. You know, you have the default setup of a speaker, which are, you know, the amplification and all the hardware, but then there's the software, and that can be totally different in this respect. So because a software update is more than just
checking
rid
one
of
thing.
Bugs, but it's also sonically. We've seen it with Illusonic.
Yeah.
Illusonic, Swiss brand, has a, let's say, a processor, but in, I think, nine or eight or ten updates, it has become another apparatus.
Oh. Yeah, I'm going to write an article about our Illusonic processor, because it's an amazing piece of equipment.
So that proves he has made hardware,
I
think 10 years ago.
Yeah.
But the improvements are software.
All software. And it sounds better every update. It's incredible.
So it's in a way, it's very difficult to review this kind of stuff, because the hardware is just one part of the story.
I'm going to conclude our introduction to Buchardt. It's a Scandinavian brand. I think Mats is a very nice guy that's very responsive to emails. I email him, I get answers, he's on the forum, you can ask him everything. These days, that's a pretty important
piece of a
brand.
You know something about
his
background? Did he work for other brands?
No, I haven't done my research on the persona yet.
Oh,
I will. It has three decks per speaker. It goes from 25 hertz to 40 kilohertz. It's pretty deep for a bookshelf speaker. And of course, for everyone, all these speakers, if you use an analog input, they will digitize it and then play it back, because it doesn't have any analog parts inside. So it has to do some AD conversion. And this one does 24/192 if you use an analog input. The hub is pretty complete. HDMI ARC, optical inputs, coaxial inputs, analog, Hume? Yeah.
Analog.
It does have analog inputs.
But it converts to digital, of course. But
yeah.
I did my phone, my
Wi-Fi and Bluetooth.
My record player on the...
Oh, yeah, you did. Yeah, that's true.
Worked.
Yeah. And one key difference, Buchardt has his own brand name on the remote, Hume. Yeah, but you don't have system audio on the remote.
Oh, but it's well.
Yeah, and it's a two-way remote, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's radio controlled.
Yeah,
which means you can. It's not, you know, infrared.
No.
So you can just put it anywhere in your home, and it works.
Let's start with Jacques Loucher. Whoa.
Oh, that's way too loud.
Whoa.
That's something different.
Yes. No compression.
No compression. Not for my...
No.
I don't feel any compression.
No.
It's a very big soundstage.
And it's very clear.
Yes.
You hear every note.
Everything.
Yeah.
In
yeah.
a good way.
You hear what yeah. you hear is the sound of the piano. It's a little bit warmer than compared to the.
I said
wow,
I
damn,
said
you're good.
I said warmer, yeah.
yeah. You're good.
Than the KADs.
Not so upfront. It's where it should be.
It's much more laid back.
Okay, yeah. influences the. I mean, you have this is wood.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah, it's MDF.
The material from the last.
Metallic.
Metallic.
Yeah.
Is that?
Yes, it does have an influence, but it. Completely depends on how they build it, because you can make an MDF cabinet very rigid and that hardly resonates. It's all about control of resonating panels in a loudspeaker, and they did a good job.
Yeah.
We've heard aluminum, loudspeakers, which are
yeah.
very musical.
Grab my attention. Yes.
Yeah.
What I think of these speakers, what was significant, I think, when you hear there's a passage in the music on the piano where yeah. there are short little notes,
yeah.
and there was space between each little note,
yeah.
and that the speed of this
yeah.
is very good.
Yeah,
so that was nice. Also.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
That's because he said you hear the difference in the speed, and I was like, well, I could hear that just exactly what you said.
Yeah.
That space in between.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, you put it in very good words. It's that's the thing. You could follow the yes. notes much better. It's a different experience, and the Devilet is all about spectacle and big, and they're small speakers, but they sound huge. And if that's what you're looking for, it's a marvelous piece of equipment.
But I'm amazed about the amount of how deep the bass
yeah, they go deep.
Such small speakers.
Yeah. Well, Mats said he did quite the same as Devialet, if I understood him correctly in the chat. The creator of the speakers is in the chat now. So I have to be very careful.
Okay.
Hi. He said, we kind of do the same as the Devialet by pushing more towards the bass end, if it's needed, in the DSP.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually fake
but somehow
bass.
It doesn't sound compressed.
No, but he did it in the good way. And of course, the Grim LS1 is also DSP controlled.
That's true. I mean,
let's
yeah.
But you don't hear it. No. And now I'm really curious about your track.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it.
I believe in star signs, and I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy, and I believe with just one glance he's crazy for my eyes. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Witchcraft. I believe in Cinderella. I believe in gypsies. And I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere in the corner. Truth and I meet face.
keep some stunning souvenirs. So I believe in heroes, and I expect that happy ending, wishing on some rainbow. I pretend he's not pretending. Someday I'll get wise. Right now, I need the lies of handsome men.
Well,
yeah. Well,
this is like listening to someone singing in front of you.
Yes, it's like live.
Yes.
It's very...
Well, it's so much warmer than the last, it's just warmer.
Well, what struck me was the boxiness of the piano. There's some notes that are...
Yes, the piano is not the best one.
It wasn't exaggerated.
No.
It wasn't disturbing, and on the KAD, I think it was even better. But hey, €10,000 difference.
If you buy a piano,
kudos. Very well done, Mats.
Yes.
But there it was even less disturbing. But here it was very well controlled.
Very musical.
Very musical, good sounding loudspeaker.
This is a speaker where you can listen to casually.
Yeah.
But also, if you want to listen with intent, then this will serve it to you as well, so
amazing. That's the size of this speaker.
Yes,
And it's the timing is fast. What I think we like fast speakers.
Yes.
It's fast. Well, it's €3,500 a pair, but I think it's without the hub and without stand mounts. You need stand mounts. I mean, come on, people, you don't put these on a bookshelf. It's ridiculous. They should be placed well in a room.
Well, since it's a closed system, you
could
do
potentially
it.
Do that.
Can
you
hang them?
Yeah, you can. Yeah, you could. We are hi-fi nerds.
Okay, sorry.
Yes, you can hang them on the ceiling, in theory.
<It's a> surround sound.
But if you want to do it well,
it's got to be this level.
You need the tweeter on ear level.
On the deck, Marnie.
Okay,
on the deck.
What? This is all stuff I'm learning through.
Yeah,
next to the barbecues. Next to the barbecues on the deck.
Oh, 37.50 with the hub. That's a good deal.
That's
because
good
the
deal.
Hub is €600 normally. So that's a very good deal.
Well, it's good to know that the level here is where it needs to be.
Yeah, these are on the right level. I'm lucky because I do have stands, but I don't have a lot of them. they're not cheap. These are cheap. You can have much better, nice looking stands than this. But they're on the right level. You need them on ear level. So I'm a little bit too high. I think you are on the correct height.
And your eyes need to be on same level as the tweeter. That's because that's more or less where your ears are. So,
What's the price for the stands? Well, you can put any stand on
them. These are Atacama, I think. They're about 200 or so.
Yeah, these are $200-$300 per pair. Wireless speaker, okay. Well, let's get to the last track.
Yeah.
Symphony. Symphony work. Thank you.
I'm gonna check one more because I have the feeling, and some people have the feeling, something is wrong with the left one.
Yeah, you will hear some static noise or something.
Yeah, it was less than was in the former track.
Less than the former one. Yes. But I'm gonna double check because it has to be fair. Yeah. No, front right. Yes. They were left right. But I'm gonna pair them again because one had static.
Yeah.
How can it happen?
We have a lot of LEDs in this room. It's ridiculous. And the disturbance from LED lighting is quite horrible.
Okay.
It's not a technical thing. They did wrong.
It's our
environment that is quite hostile to wireless. Front left.
Now I hear it again. Tick.
Now that's the pairing part.
Okay.
Front right. Yes, they should.
But what I noticed already with the, even if the left speaker is maybe not completely as it should be, is the sound of wood instruments, wood blowers, and copper is a little bit warmer instead, but there's a little also clarity, so it's not like overly warm. It's a little bit warmer, which is pleasing to hear, to listen to, but there's still detail in the instruments.
Okay,
so that's good. Yeah,
and let's check if can Martijn hear us? Yeah, probably. If everything is all right on that side. They are paired again, and let's see if this track sounds different now.
Yeah.
I noticed something as well. Mats, thank you for pointing this out. They were on left and right, but they needed pairing again, obviously.
Why is that?
Technically, the LEDs said left, right, but it didn't pair it with the hub, so the hub sent it out the wrong. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
You're not gonna get this at home, believe me. We do four pairs of speakers. You pair them, and they're okay normally.
Because there's too much signals fighting for the same.
That and loads of LEDs that just fuck.
What was impressive is at the very start of this track, when they play very low dynamics.
Yeah.
Then there is this build up of the horn and the hobos getting louder and louder and louder, going up to the first. And that. A crescendo being made, that's very, very nice to hear on this set of speakers. And that's, I'm impressed. There is a difference, of course, with the first speakers that we had, because there is, well,
scale. And the control, even better.
But the sound stage of the orchestra is really good.
Yeah.
I will listen at home and try different tunings to see if the placement of the instruments in that soundstage of the orchestra
be. Yeah, this is just
could
flat.
Be different. Yeah.
Nothing. We did nothing. Yeah. I want to hear your track one more time in stereo, please, if you're okay with that.
Yep.
It will take a little bit longer to stream then, but I think everyone needs a fair fight.
Yeah.
And they played in mono, so that's not fair.
But in mono, it already
sounded... It was really good in mono.
Somebody even wrote Goosebumps or something, right?
Yeah, true.
But I'm curious how that...
But tonality was the same, but it's just the soundstage that... and your track is probably mixed in mono anyway, so... Not completely.
Nee. No. Groter.
I believe in star signs, and I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy, and I believe with just one glance he's crazy for my eyes, 'cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Witchcraft. I believe in Cinderella. I believe in gypsies. And I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies. 'Cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere in the corner of my blind, and even though he's hooked me on his line, I find the pleasure's been mine. I believe in love songs, they seem to know just what I'm feeling. I believe Prince Charming, I never guess he's double dealing. How my spirits rise, believing in the lies of handsome men. Sometimes in a dark and quiet place, the truth and I meet face to face. And even if His Highness disappears, I keep some stunning souvenirs. So I believe in heroes, and I expect that happy ending, wishing on some rainbow. Someday I'll get wise, but right now I need the lies of handsome men.
You flew away to another place.
Yeah, well.
Okay, well, this was in stereo.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, guys. It. Yeah, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, really good.
Super.
Super good speaker.
It's a little bit larger than life.
Yeah, it is.
So your voice is bigger than what you would expect when you would be on stage with a microphone.
Yeah.
But the effect it gives,
I think that's the mix, because when you would listen it in the
it's also large
in the mixing room.
Yeah,
you would also hear that because we chose the reverb.
Ah,
sorry, we're pretty nerdy. When we chose this is what it does with the when you we could listen to it later on, but in a control room.
You think it's quite accurate?
I think it's quite accurate.
Yes. Okay.
Wow.
I think it's quite accurate for the mix.
I think it sounds very, very neutral to my feeling. It doesn't exaggerate bass or mids or heights. It's very well balanced. I like a balanced speaker because I think if a speaker gives his own signature, all music will sound the same. And I want to hear the recording. I think he did a good job.
Yes.
You're going to try out the master
tunings. Well, I think I need about half a year for it, I guess.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, I think so.
Maybe a year.
Maybe a year. Maybe we
get the review after a month, but then you need a year.
So 10 years, do you have your journal, your daily journal?
Yeah. I'm gonna swap out for the last pair.
Okay.
You're gonna do the
same intro.
The same intermezzo.
The same intermezzo.
Yeah.
Where is it?
This is our intermezzo leech. Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad, but the world goes round. And sometimes you lose every nickel you've had, but the world goes round. And sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a fall and a spring. And sometimes a friend starts treating you bad, but the world goes round. And sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound.
Yes, ready.
I'm ready.
That was perfectly timed, see?
We
knew it.
Now I need some
noise.
Come on. Okay. Coax.
Boven the koelkast.
Yeah. Iets harder. Noise. Okay, Martino, hij mag weer op mono even.
Kent de broodvlag, ja precies.
Ja, ja. Voordeel, die dingen zijn super snel goed te zetten. Alright, was you mine?
I don't know. I think it became a little bit too much for him.
Yeah, but he needs to introduce the system audio loudspeakers. Yeah, he will probably be back. System audio.
Ja, kan ik?
Also, Wytha loudspeaker. You're going to compare this one to the Buchardt. Well, it's going to be a tough match, I think. Whew. Ah, there he is.
Water.
Thanks. Jung, you had these at home.
Yes.
For a couple of...
For 10 years.
For 10 years, yeah. Well, you had them a long time.
Yes, I was waiting for the show.
Yes. That's no problem. I'm not judging you, but
well, the nice thing about these speakers is they are so small.
Yeah, they're very small.
Yes.
And actually, in the house, people like them. And the setup was also a piece of cake. My room at home is pretty small, so 4 by 4 meters where I tried it. So it was, and it's very pretty low. So it was pretty bass heavy, but that I didn't try it with DSP, but that's the thing you want to use DSP for, to yeah. adjust it to your room.
Yeah.
But immediately you could hear that this was a, well, more or less, I think, I expected to be comparable to the Buchardts, actually. Mm-hmm.
They are a little bit cheaper.
Yes, a little bit, but...
Not too much. These are 2500.
You can also can get these bigger. Yeah. They have floor standards. But it was very easy to do. You just, the only thing you have to do when you install it yourself is just follow the manual. So don't be stubborn and say, okay, I can do it. I can do it just myself. You have to, if they say something, you just do it.
Yeah.
I was getting fond of this one because when you adjust the volume in Rune or whatever, that it, you see, it already is, it's tactile also.
It lights up and it tells you what the volume
so
is.
So the volume goes down if you put it down in, maybe you can try it in Rune, but it's and it works very well. It's what you said, with wireless you want ease of use.
Yes.
You don't want bugs or something.
Well, system audio, Scandinavian?
Yeah,
it's Danish.
Danish. Yeah. Yes. Buchardt as well.
Yes.
So, a lot of good speaker brands are Nordic. And Seos is a Nordic brand as well.
Yeah.
They deliver the units for the KAD. It's one Danish party here. What's up with Denmark?
Yeah, I don't know. Well, there's something about, because we had some... It wasn't easy finding let's say this these four speakers we are getting together.
Yeah.
Now you know, there are not that many brands that do have speakers and of course agree to this kind of testing.
No, not all of the brands like being compared online this, okay. Because it's
but
very
some,
confronting.
Somehow there's something about Scandinavian, they trust their own stuff. And they don't mind being reviewed in this way. But there are more wireless speakers, of course. There are more brands.
Not as many as you would think.
Nope.
There are not as many. DALI has the clear audio system they use with the wireless
Wilkins formation series.
Is Wi-Fi. Yes, the Duo is the only speaker that could be standing here, but the platform is not really finished. Sorry. Kef Wireless, LS50 Wireless, the new Meta, could be here. I think 2,000 a pair, the big one.
Yeah, 2.5.
They didn't want to. Din Audio, but they don't have a new model yet. Okay. And the old one is not being produced anymore.
Yeah, that was it, yeah.
Then you have, I really have to think hard. Harman Formation. They didn't even answer me.
Harman Formation?
Yeah.
Yep.
Formation. It's like a... Sonos on steroids as well. Klipsch, they said, okay, who's competing? Okay, then we don't want to be there. About trusting your own product. So it's hard to get, there are not as many. Some we didn't ask. I mean, you know they won't be able to compete. And
Dan Olsen?
Could be, but we don't have a... Yeah.
Well, they didn't answer our prayers.
Either. There were some that we tried, and these are, of course, here. A few just didn't want to.
Yeah, okay. Some short specs on the speaker, then we'll listen. 150 watts per speaker, 2 amps per speaker. That's, so every driver has its own speaker. That's pretty normal. Specifications are 40 hertz at the lowest. To 25 kilohertz. I didn't hear that, to be honest. It was pretty bassy.
Yeah,
bass.
It's pretty complete.
Legend DXT tweeter and 15/4 woofer DSP controlled. And it's light, it's 7 kilos a speaker.
Whoa.
Yeah, they're very light. A lot lighter than the Buchards.
And it has
but
a
maybe
nice
you will hear the wood now.
I was just.
And it has a nice form.
I was thinking that. I'm like, am I obsessed with if it's wood or not?
No, that's a good obsession because you actually do hear the cabinet.
Okay.
So it also has WiSA. So it has HDMI, which is very neat if you use it with your TV.
Yeah.
Optical, coaxial, RCA, mini jack, USB B, USB A.
It's the same hub as the Buchardt, so connectivity is the same. It's just this is bass reflex with less power, and that's it.
Yeah.
Really. So let's try. Here we go, Martijn. Right, the dropout, I have no clue. Could
no,
be
that
once.
Was, yeah.
But
there are little gremlins in his room, I think.
Yeah, but there are actually gremlins in his room in the power room. We know that. The LEDs sometimes do this. They're looking into it. It's a big
Maybe
factory.
Maybe we could switch off the other
I'm going to switch off the other WiSA stuff, because that could be actually
because
interfering.
Because I have the idea that it has And it's stressed.
It's the same channel, so you normally have one hub, and now there are three hubs active. So that's.
And the blinking one.
Yeah, that is the for the.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Nee, deze laat ik wel even aan. De primaire stond nog aan. Dat zou wel kunnen.
En die Buchardt is uit.
Ja, die is uit. Okay. Ja. Okay. Let's see, because normally you don't have two hubs standing together next to each other. That's actually.
Heel even kort, Lucie, in 10 seconds.
Nou, we pakken zo al jullie track. Dan kunnen we hem. First impression.
First impression is it's a little less speedy than the Buchardt ones. So that's one thing. The sound of the piano and the bass is. A bit more has more weight to it.
Yeah.
It's also very natural sounding, so that's nice. I like that when it's when you hear the instrument that's actually being played, that you can almost say it's the brand. This brand's playing piano, but that's what it sounds like. So that's very nice. And well, it's a big sound stage from such small speakers. That's amazing. Yeah.
I was also amazed by the scale. Yeah. It plays
big,
a lot bigger than you think.
Yes.
When you see such a small speaker, I do hear now. Now we're listening more concentrated. The difference between a closed system and yes. bass reflex. Yes. It's quite obvious in the Chaclouché
yeah.
track.
Oh yes. Yeah.
The bass kick is tighter on the Buchardt.
Yeah.
And but this speaker has more weight in the mid bass, like the chest when you sing, than the Buchardt. But it could be coloration.
Well, I felt like you could hear the bass and the high, like with the one speaker.
The white one?
Between the white and the little sci-fi.
Oh, yeah.
You could hear higher tones in the little black guy.
Yeah, but definitely.
But this you could hear the low and the high.
Yeah, both the same.
You mentioned in the middle, so that's interesting. Yeah. In the middle, but I'm hearing low and high, so maybe that is.
I don't know. Yeah, I call it mid bass, but yeah, doesn't matter. I think we mean the same thing. It struck me this time, but the skill is impressive.
It sounded more relaxed at home. That's why I was a little bit
more relaxed.
Yeah, it was.
So let's try it with
let's
the other
try track. Your track.
So I don't know if a speaker can feel stressed, but I felt that it had more stress.
It is playing a lot louder now because of the room.
Sure, that's possible.
Yeah, and small speakers that you actually do push will sound less relaxed. And that was quite impressive from the Buchardt. It was playing pretty loud and it was still not stressed.
Now what's the okay.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
At what level is it playing now?
Three quarters, I think.
Three quarters?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, it's pretty loud. Here we go.
300 watt, man.
Here we go.
I believe in star signs, and I believe in film romances. I believe in fantasy, and I believe with just one glance he's crazy for my eyes, 'cause I believe the lies of handsome men. I believe in witchcraft, I believe in Cinderella, I believe in gypsies, and I believe I cast a spell that sends him to the skies, 'cause I believe the lies of handsome men. Somewhere in the corner of my mind, I'm not a fool, completely blind. And even if His Highness disappears,
some stunning souvenirs.
Je hoort het geluid van de pianobenen.
Ja. I think it's quite impressive for a small speaker, but I do hear a difference with the Buchardt.
Yes,
that's for sure. That's,
yeah, I think you need it in. This is for a small room or a moderate room. It's okay. Yeah.
We're putting it on 3/4 of its power, so it's impressive that I don't notice it. It's playing really loud now for such a small
speaker.
I think
you would need the floor standard.
Yeah. In this case, yes.
Is a more
space actually for this?
For this one, I think 20-30 square meters. This is
100. I had it in 16, and it was, you know, I had it on. Yeah. 3 out of 10, you know, it was
now it's
already blowing me away.
Really on 3/4. So
in a normal room with this room is treated, you know, it's a studio.
Yeah, but there's a difference in the weight to the sound. I mean, what you call the mid bass, the chest in your voice, it's more pronounced.
Yeah.
And what I also noticed, which I thought was how do you call it, a standout, was that the reverb of the sound was bigger, but it sounded a little bit on the artificial side.
Yeah,
it
sounded far away.
Yeah,
I was saying it sounded like it was
up there.
Smaller and further away.
Yeah,
to compare with the other ones.
Yeah, but the echo, how tones die out and things like that. It's different, but it sounds like a bit. It's well, there's maybe the DSP working.
No, I'm gonna power cycle them once before the next track.
Yep,
just to be sure. I don't think it's same issue as Buchardt, but just to be sure. Now it's on front left. But it's...
But on the whole, it's amazing how this speaker performs, because if you would buy a comparable speaker of this size, we wouldn't be talking about reverb.
No. If you would buy a comparable speaker... I mean, this is not a comparable speaker. This is a complete system.
Yes.
Yes.
With a speaker in it also. And for what they do in this size cabinet and what comes out of it.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's really impressive. But that's the power of active speakers.
Yes.
You buy a system, it's all matched together.
You only need your
power
plug.
Just plug them in and it's gone. And I mean, the issues we had, you won't have at home, because they're not 3 WiSA hubs next to each other and 4 speaker systems next to each other.
100 LEDs.
And a load of LEDs that can... we didn't have any issues on Friday in that part, but yeah.
I like, I mean, it's a little bit colored, but it's like a coloration in the music, which I think a lot of people like, actually. So if you sit at home and you have to listen to these speakers I think a lot of people, me including, would be very, very happy with this.
And if you would look closer to the form, you know, it's shaped like this. So at home, people say, "Hey, it's a nice speaker." So it's not.
They're small. They sound big. They sound nice. I mean, it does color a little bit, but it's a soothing kind of coloration. Yes. Let's not forget, for all people that are watching now, the Buchardt and this system and other WiSA systems as well can be tuned to surround. And that's a pretty cool feature.
Wow.
I mean, you don't have to have speaker wiring through the room. You just plug them in at the rear, you put a sub next to it, and you're done. For me, I like that. Yep. It's pretty cool. Last track.
Thank you.
Plays soft. I mean, the lower end of the dynamics.
It's really good.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it really pulled me into the music. I said, okay.
Yeah.
We all got excited. Did you see that? On the edge of our chairs, like, ooh, that's cool.
Yeah.
There is respect to this speaker. Yeah.
Respect.
What is obvious, very obvious to me, a very obvious difference with the previous ones here is also that the soundstage is very correct.
Yeah.
So the placing of the instruments in the soundstage and an orchestra really is spot on. And
really correct.
Maybe it's the design of the speaker or the tuning or whatever it is, but it's. That was very obvious.
I think I'm actually quite impressed by how they put this in this room at this volume. Holy shit!
Yeah,
I know a lot of speakers that can't do this.
No.
Yeah.
At loud volume, when the orchestra was going really loose. That's why I chose this track, because that is a lot of dynamics.
Yeah.
Then it's hard. Were pushing the speakers, but I think that's the size of the room and the insane. Volume that you have.
The Buchardt was on half, and it's a bigger speaker with a third.
It's only 300 watts per speaker, so the other one was
450 per speaker.
450.
Yeah, so there's a big difference. And yes, it was more relaxed and more controlled.
Yeah.
But you get what you pay for in this case.
But the thing is, I think at home I listened to the what you heard on the low level. So that's what it. You said, oh, wow. Okay.
Yes. I said to you, I said, that's so pleasant. It might sound like a soft word, but was really inviting and really like.
I think they're
I was listening to the horns, copper is a very good giveaway of how a speaker is tuned or what it sounds like, what its characteristics are. So the horns were like listening to a English system almost. I mean, I wouldn't say this is. I wouldn't say this is coming from Scandinavia.
Could be the tuning, because you can actually put master tunings in this as well. I just read.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
yes, but this is neutral.
It should be.
Yeah, this is neutral.
But rounding off, because we're way into the afternoon. We need lunch. I need lunch. You need lunch? Yes, you do.
We have to sing. We have to sing.
First, KAD K7.
That was in. How the voice was portrayed in the track that we recorded, that was amazing.
Bizarre.
That was really something else.
Really got me.
Yeah. Me too.
Very tight controlled, very fast paced, but for me a little bit on the dry side. So maybe you can also tune it, or it can be tuned for it.
I think so.
And maybe it's a little bit drier, and in this very dry environment, maybe it sounds different when you have it in a normal home.
I guess so.
But I was impressed by, the speed of that and the control of that speaker. Oh,
the glorious mid-range.
Yes.
Yes, I loved it.
Yeah.
Devialet. the egg.
Super cool.
Super cool.
But the sound, for to hear the voice come out so extremely different than what we experienced the time before, that was a bit, it was a different experience. That's how you could put it. No. And where is the environment that you're listening to it and everything like that?
I think if you are listening to a lot of electronic music, and you
are
mind-blowingly good,
the volume as well was like,
Or you're throwing a lot of parties, then the Devialet is
different target group.
Yes, absolutely.
But I think it's a very cool product.
It is.
Yes.
Yeah, it's an experience. It got me. By playing at such a skill you don't expect from a speaker like that. Technically, awesome.
Yeah.
That is, it's looking for the boundaries of what's possible in such a small form factor, I think. Buchardt, Jung.
Well, I think, it surprised me the largeness of the sound and the it almost sounded like a floor standing speaker in terms of power and a very pleasant highs, overall very very pleasant, nice sounding speaker.
Would you pay €1,000 extra on top of this? That's the difference we're talking about.
€1,000?
Yeah, per pair.
Depends on my room. I think when I would have my
good one.
I would look for my 4x4 room. This one would do, I think.
Good one.
Perfectly do, but in my living room downstairs or?
Yeah, you have a large living room. It's going to be hard. It's pretty big, yes.
What I really liked about the Buchardt was the scale of the soundstage.
Yeah.
That was without getting overblown. I mean, it was a big presentation, but it still sounded right. Enough power to have some room for.
And going back to KAD, sorry for the. When Friday I came in and you were playing this and playing it, and even outside of the studio, it sounded
really
good. You know.
Wow.
So it has something. Maybe that's the phase correctness of it.
I think so.
So you don't have to be on a sweet spot to have a good sound. So there was no bass heavy. A place in a studio or in a room. It was even pleasant to hear it from outside the room.
It's funny you say that because that's one of their stokpaardjes, like we call it in
Hobby
Dutch.
Horses.
Stokpaardje.
Stokpaardje.
Yeah, that you can sit anywhere and it will sound good.
Well, you can even sit nowhere, so outside of the room.
Outside it's even good. So
I had
the same kudos.
Same with my, I have quested monitors, the big ones, and they're the same. It's as if, you know, if you are playing flute in room one, I can sit outside and still, he's playing flute.
Mm-hmm.
And the question do have that,
it's
the same.
Actually true. Yeah.
The same experience. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty cool.
And the system audios, I think they're pretty cool for their size. They're small. They're small speakers.
They're really small speakers with a big sound.
Yeah.
It's and a very pleasing sound to the ear. So it's not neutral.
Yeah.
I don't think it's very neutral in its representation, mm-hmm. but in a good way. I mean, that can be in a bad way, but this time it's in a good way. And if you have to listen to this all day,
you can.
Happy.
Yeah, you'll be happy. So best mid-range KAD, best experience and impressiveness is definitely Devialet. Buchardt, I think, was very coherent.
And the sound of this voice came out.
That was really well.
But it was really like comparable to the first. Yeah. I thought the warmness of it.
Nice balance.
Small.
And best performance for size.
Yes.
System audio. I mean, plays really big.
Well, and if thinking about these are the cheapest from
The
bunch.
Yeah, 25 per pair.
That's you get a lot for your money.
Yes. Yeah. And on that bombshell, you will play two more tracks.
We have time
for it. Or one or two. Let's. I'll leave it up to you. This was Wireless
speaker systems, thank you for watching the first live stream of the year.
The next one will be?
End of the month, but I'll make a planning so you can join us again.
Always the last Sunday of the month, right?
Yeah, normally it's every last Sunday of the month. Yeah. But
we're not normal, so.
Yeah.
Yep.
Up to you.
Okay, guys.
Yes.
Go.
Thank you.
And thank you for singing for us today.
Yeah.
Yes.
Definitely. Yeah.
Ging maar doen. Dingen, hè?
When I was a boy?
Yes. Heb je daar iets over gezegd?
Yeah, the first song is When I Was a Boy. It's written by Dar Williams. And the second is Nothing Rhymed. Gilbert O'Sullivan. Ja, een beetje opwarmen weer. I won't forget when Peter Pan came to my house, took my hand. I said I was a boy. I'm glad he didn't check. I learned to fly, I learned to fight. We lived a whole life in one night. We saved each other's lives out on the pirate deck. And I remember leaving a late night with some friends. I heard somebody tell me it's not safe, someone should help me. I need to find a nice man to walk me home. When I was a boy, I scared the pants off of my mom. I climbed what I could climb upon. And I don't know how I survived. I guess I knew the tricks that all boys knew. And you can walk me home. But I was a boy too. I was a kid that you would like, just a small boy on her bike, riding topless, yeah, I never cared who saw. My neighbor came outside to say, "Get your shirt!" I said, "No way! It's the last time, I'm not breaking any law." And now I'm in this clothing store where the sign says less is more. More that's tight means more to see, more for them, not more for me. That can help me climb a tree in 10 seconds flat. When I was a boy, see that picture, that was me. Grass-stained shirt and dusty knees. And I know things have got to change. They've got pills to sell, they've got implants to put in. They've got implants to remove. But I am not forgetting that I was a boy too. And like the woods where I would creep, it's a secret I could keep, except when I'm tired, except when I'm caught off guard. I've had a lonesome, awful day, and the conversation finds its way to catching fireflies out in the backyard. And so I tell the man I'm with about the other life I've lived, and I say, "Now you're Top Gun, I have lost and you have won." And he says, "Oh no, can't you see? When I was a girl, my mom and I, we always talked, and I picked flowers everywhere that I walked. And I could always cry. Now even when I'm alone, I seldom do. And I have lost some kindness, but I was a girl too. And you were just like me. And I was just like you." Thank you.
Okay.
Last one.
I just have to do a quick grab. 1 second, 2 seconds. Something got came. Okay. Right, sound we? Sound clear? We're ready to go. Something didn't rhyme.
Great.
Gilbert O'Sullivan. Seat I've been saving to some elderly lady or man. Am I being a good girl? Am I still your sweet girl? Mother, please, if you think, say I am. While in the course of my duty I perform an unfortunate take, would you punish me so unbelievably so? Never again will I make that mistake. This feeling inside me could never deny me the right to be wrong if I choose. And this pleasure I get from, say, winning a bet is to lose. While I'm drinking my Bonaparte shandy, eating more than enough apple pies, while I glance at my screen and see real human beings starve to death right in front of my eyes. Nothing old, nothing new, nothing ventured, nothing gained, nothing stillborn or lost, nothing further than proof, nothing wilder than youth, nothing older than time, nothing sweeter than wine, nothing physically recklessly, hopelessly blind, nothing I couldn't say, nothing why, 'cause today nothing rhymed. This feeling inside me could never deny me the right to be wrong if I choose. And this pleasure I get from, say, winning a bet is to lose. Nothing old, nothing new, nothing ventured, nothing gained, nothing stillborn or lost, nothing further than proof, nothing wilder than youth, nothing older than time, nothing sweeter than wine, nothing physically, recklessly, hopelessly blind, nothing I couldn't say, nothing why, 'cause today
Michelle. Well, lots of compliments from our viewers.
Thank you.
So, Jung, last words.
Famous last words.
You're tired and want to eat.
Yeah, I'm tired.
Okay.
I want to lunch.
So we're going to have some lunch.
Send food quickly.
We're going to have some dinner, people. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.